Hey everybody, hello patriots and digital soldiers and information warriors. Here is the additional proof and evidence that Brian D. Hill, formerly of USWGO Alternative News, was actually innocent of his charge of child pornography in 2013. He was tortured in federal custody in 2014 into a false guilty plea. That violates the voluntary plea process that the U.S. Supreme Court had previously ruled that all confessions to a crime, including guilty pleas, must be knowingly and voluntary, and that Brian being tortured into making a false guilty plea when the federal prosecutor presented a fraudulent case against Brian, makes the plea agreement process illegally administered. Brian has indeed proven his innocence, as shown in the last video released on USWGO YouTube channel titled Proof That Brian D. Hill, USWGO Alternative News, is innocent, being held hostage by corrupt federal court. That is because not only did he prove fraud on the court in all of Brian's criminal case and of his fraudulent probation violation convictions, which was uncontested by the government lawyers, but this video will show the evidence that he was also tortured into falsely pleading guilty. Torture can come in many forms to induce coercion and duress to obtain a false confession or guilty plea. Modern forms of torture in federal or state jails or prisons can include deprivation of proper medical care, or not enough medical care to maintain good health instead of health deterioration. In fact, historically the Knights Templars were tortured into falsely confessing to a crime, and then the ruler ordered the assassination of the Knights Templars on Friday the 13th. The same technique is being used currently on the January 6, 2021 protesters and those who had entered the United States Capitol building after being led in by Antifa and federal goons. They are treating the federal prisoners inhumanely on purpose to induce possibly false guilty pleas or false confessions to achieve the results that the corrupt United States Department of Justice are pushing for. The same style inhumane treatments was being done to Brian D. Hill of USWGO Alternative News in December 2013 to November 2014. Brian was patient zero long before the inhumane treatment and deprivation of constitutional rights for the January 6th protesters and those who had entered the Capitol building. In Brian's case, he was tortured by usage of medical neglect and not being given reasonable bond conditions on purpose to keep Brian in jail for many months. Brian was tortured by not being given enough diabetic insulin necessary to not only sustain Brian's life but to prevent organ damage and any permanent damage caused by type 1 brittle diabetes. Brian filed pages of medical records proving these facts. Brian's family wanted him released but was given terrible bond conditions after he was arrested by Department of Homeland Security. The bond conditions were that Brian would be under 24-hour home detention and not be allowed to even use a simple telephone, so he couldn't even ask his pretrial services probation officer to get permission to even leave his home to do any essential activities. Even the jails have paytel and phone conversation recording services at the detention facilities. So why wouldn't the feds allow Brian to simply use a telephone? Why was Brian given conditions for bond that would be very easy to violate, and that simply using a telephone to even get permission to modify the bond conditions or get permission to even leave the home would violate his conditions for even attempting to phone call the supervising officer he would be assigned if Brian had been released on bond? This was done on purpose by the United States Probation Office of Greensboro, North Carolina, like by the deep state swamp. Brian was being given severely unreasonable bond conditions, making it even impossible for him to pick up medical prescriptions such as insulin, and Brian couldn't even contact his supervising officer without violating bond and would face more charges such as bond revocation and violation of bond. So they purposefully made it so that even trying to get permission from the probation officer conducting pretrial services supervision would violate his bond conditions. Brian's family wanted the lawyer Eric David Plack, the assistant federal public defender of Greensboro, to push for better bond conditions, but he refused and made it impossible for Brian to have reasonable bond conditions. He was given better supervised release conditions as part of his probation after he falsely pleaded guilty. Brian wasn't just tortured but also gave incentives that he be given better supervision conditions and medical treatment upon falsely pleading guilty and getting an imprisonment sentence of time already served. So Brian's family were forced to let Brian be medically tortured in Orange County Detention Center, Forsyth County Detention Center, Greensboro, North Carolina Jail, and Butner, North Carolina. When he was in the jail system for the feds, he was not allowed to do his own insulin shots and was dependent on nurses who only came at certain time intervals each and every day, which was in contradiction with the insulin orders given by his medical doctor paid for by Medicaid. Brian was supposed to be given insulin each time he eats, and have a snack at night to prevent low blood sugar, as well as taking nighttime insulin every night or morning. Read the medical documents which Brian had filed in his 2255 case and exhibits, his actual innocence claim. One of the elements of his actual innocence claim was that Brian was being medically neglected, aka tortured. In fact, the torture got so bad that a few U.S. Marshals deputies, normally would corruptly go along with the judicial corruption, they actually felt sorry for Brian when they checked his diabetic blood sugar glucose levels and was dangerously high over 500 on two different occasions. They finally understood that Brian was being tortured and they could no longer stand by and do nothing, so the U.S. Marshals took Brian to Moses Cone Hospital in Greensboro, North Carolina. Brian got insulin and did a medical record on this. Brian's sentencing hearing for his child pornography conviction was in fact rescheduled. Another fact in addition to the torture was that the public defenders do not conduct thorough investigations, they will not do much research if at all. They usually tell their clients to plead guilty whether false or true. Torture is one part of the false guilty pleas and the other part is lawyers who do nothing to defend you and do absolutely nothing to prove your innocence. You can read through the court transcript of the court hearing dated September 3, 2014, as well as the transcript date of the hearing on September 30, 2014, and read the account of Brian's grandparents and mother. The night before Brian's case went to trial, they found out that his attorney was lazy and didn't have any defense, so he called the family on the phone the night before Brian's trial and talked all in the family to pressure Brian to give a guilty plea the next morning, or Brian would go to prison because this attorney had no defense and the prosecuting attorney did have an argument good enough to persuade a stigmatized jury to convict him, and asserted that he would get 20 years in prison, despite the facts that the statutory maximum for Brian's charge was 10 years imprisonment unless new charges were to be filed under a superseding indictment. This created a major conflict in the federal court record of pleading guilty and yet filing multiple handwritten affidavits proclaiming actual innocence after the false guilty plea. That conflict has yet to be resolved even in the year 2021. So Brian had still maintained his innocence even after falsely pleading guilty but did as his family had asked him to do and was angry at his family the next day after his fake guilty plea because he was innocent. His attorney would not let Brian have the discovery or read it and refused for his family to read it. That was partially what led up to Brian's Freedom of Information Act lawsuit, which was filed after Brian did not receive a copy of all criminal case discovery evidence material, and the United States Attorney Office admitted that the State Bureau of Investigation forensic report and his false confession audio were all destroyed, and so Brian lost the Freedom of Information Act lawsuit under the corrupt federal judge Jackson L. Kaiser of Danville, Virginia Federal Courthouse. After Brian came home after being released on an imprisonment sentence of time already served in exchange for his false guilty plea, the family including Brian D. Hill was allowed on January 22, 2015, to finally review over the discovery materials for his criminal case together and found out that alleged child pornography was allegedly downloading to Brian's laptop computer for 11 months after the police confiscated his computer. This was all typed by North Carolina SBI agent Rodney V. White of the Greensboro State Bureau of Investigation office. A virus perhaps, or maybe it was planted with the intent of ruining this man for operating USWGO alternative news. His family has sworn in affidavits as to Brian's innocence with proof on the federal court records and went to the trouble to make sure the court would have it. If any judges or attorneys read all of the proof of his innocence, Brian would be a free man today. Or did they read it and are so corrupt? Anybody who takes the time to review over the Hazel Atlas motions filed by Brian in 2019, or reviewed over his claims in the brief of his 2255 motion with his actual innocence claim and saw the government did not contest or dispute Brian's fraud claims would have no doubt that this man is innocent of his federal charge of possession of child pornography. As to the January 6, 2021 Washington, D.C. pro-Trump protesters, they were given the same type of inhumane treatment and coercion to obtain a false guilty plea favorable only to the government. So in addition to the facts of Brian's actual innocence and being held hostage by the corrupt federal judges and being held hostage by the federal courts in Greensboro and Winston-Salem, North Carolina, the evidence of the torture of Brian D. Hill is shown in this video and links to such evidence listed in the description below the video on whatever video streaming website this video is being uploaded to. Please share this video with every patriot you know. The evidence links should be in the video description. This is a video prepared for Stanley Bolton channels and will be posted on alternative platforms for sharing patriotic videos. Justice for Brian D. Hill of USWGO Alternative News. Justice for USWGO.wordpress.com or Justice for USWGO.nl. Video speech prepared on July 29 to 30, 2021. Thank you, American patriots and patriots worldwide. Where we go, one we go all. God bless you all.